Hello everyone, myself is Dr. Jyoti Gangurde, Assistant Professor of Zoology, KTHM College, Nashik. Students, today we are going to discuss on the topic Blister beetle and its scientific name, that is Mylabris pustulata. Now, first come to the general introduction of this blister beetle or such a Mylabris pustulata. Now here, such a blister beetle or the adult blister beetles on disturbance, okay? If we can disturb such a blister beetle, they emit a defensive oily fluid. Now such a fluid which containing blistering agent, okay? So which causing a blister or which causing the itching, okay? So this is what the blister is. Now, so which containing the blistering agent or such an agent which is nothing but the cathartin, okay? Such a cathartin, which is a chemical compound. Now, such a blister beetle or the adult blister beetles, if we can disturb them, they emit a kind of fluid, a kind of chemical, which can cause itching or which can cause blister, okay, or which can, cause a boil, okay. Now, such a chemical compound, which is a cathartin. Now, such a blister beetle, which is the only important pest of the agricultural plant such as bajra, okay, which occasionally breaks out in epidemic form in some localities, okay, which can form an epidemic. Now, the grubs, okay, its developing stages, the grubs, they feed on the eggs of grasshoppers in soil and they are therefore beneficial, okay. Now, here, the developing stages of such a blister beetle. Okay, now they are feeding on the eggs of grasshopper. Now we already know that the grasshoppers, okay, they laid their eggs in the crevices of the soil. Okay, so by this habitat, okay, the grubs of such a blister beetle, they can feed on the eggs of grasshoppers in soil. And therefore, such a blister beetles or the developing stages particularly, they are beneficial. Okay, now, but the adults, okay, adults, if we can disturb them, then and then only they can cause the blister or they can release a particular kind of chemical which can cause blister or itching or redness. Okay, now, if we can discuss regarding its systemic position, okay, now, the systemic or the systematic position here such a includes which belongs to phylum Arthropoda. Now, as we already know that the Arthropoda or the arthros are nothing but the jointed appendages, okay. Now, here the exoskeleton or the body surface, okay, which is made up of a chitin material. Now, the class Insecta. Now, here the class Insecta, particularly the body of such a insect which is divisible into head, thorax as well as in abdomen, okay, and along with that such a insects, they shows a presence of three pair of legs, okay, and that's why we also call them as a hexapoda. Okay, now the order Coleoptera. Now, here the characteristic feature of Coleopteran insect that the forewings, they are highly sclerotized and such a forewings, they are hard and such a forewings, they are called as a elytra. Now, such a modified forewings, okay, such a modified forewings, they are hard, they cover the entire abdominal surface of the beetle or the insect, okay. Now, and such a forewings, underneath the surface of forewings, the membranous thin hindwings, they are overlapped, okay, and they get protected, and such a forewings, they are called as the elytra, and this is what regarding the order Coleoptera. Now, the family Mylabris, it is the family of blister beetle that has blistering chemical, particularly the cathartin, okay, genus Mylabris and the species pustulata. Now, here, if we can discuss regarding its distribution, okay. Now, such a blister beetles, they commonly found in India, followed by China, Sri Lanka, okay, and again Java. Now, it is found throughout India, including the altitude where the high climatic conditions or the at the high altitude and particularly in Himalayas, okay, Himalaya, where the temperature which is cold, right, but it is at high altitude. So they are found particularly at the higher altitude or Himalaya, as well as they also found in the plains of North and South India. Okay, now after that come to its host plants. Now host plants which mainly includes the plants such as bajra, jowar, then paddy, cucurbits and beans. Now it is polyphagous pest, means along with that particular crop plant which is feeding on again so many plants. Okay, so it is polyphagous pest, as it feeds on different unrelated plant species in agriculture and forest ecosystem. Now the blister beetles, they are also known to feed on many flowers and ornamental plants also. Now they are commonly noticed feeding on flowers of hibiscus. Okay, and we already familiar with the hibiscus plant. Okay, now it has been also reported that which can damage the plants such as peas, then maize, sorghum, pearl, millet, cucurbits, cotton, rose, groundnuts and lady's finger. Okay, means along with the particular host plant which is also found on the different plants also, or collectively what we say is that it is polyphagous in nature. Okay, then come to its identification. Okay, now the identification mark which include, okay, you can see in the diagram, this is the adult blister beetle. Now here the adult beetles, they are well built, bigger in their body size and near about which measures 2 to 3 cm long and 1 cm thick. Now the body which is elongate, black or dark brown, colored with yellowish brown strips across their forewings. Okay, here you can see these are the strips. Okay, they are along their forewings. Now the soft body which is covered or protected by inner thicker elytra. Okay, so here you can see this is the elytra. Elytra which is hard and which is made up of a material which is nothing but the chitin. Okay, now underneath, okay, these are the forewings and we call them as a elytra. And underneath this elytra, the keen membranous wings, they get protected. Now here the head which is broad and vertical, here you can see the head which is broad, okay, it is a broad and which is vertical. So the prothorax, here you can see this is the small prothorax. Okay, the prothorax is distinctly narrower than the wings and head. Now here it appears as the insect has a neck. Okay, here you can see, here this is the thorax or which the prothorax, and here which is narrower, okay, which is narrower and therefore it appears as a neck of insect. Now after that the forewings, they are much hardened to form horny sheaths or elytra. Now the hind wings are membranous. Okay, here hind wings, they are below the surface of this forewings. Okay, now the hind wings are membranous and transparent. Here the adult beetles on disturbance, okay, they emit a defensive oily fluid which containing blistering agent. Okay, and such the agent which is the cathartin, such a cathartin which is a chemical compound and which may forms blistering and severe skin reaction, okay, which can form a boil or either, okay, reddening of the skin. Okay, this is what all about the identification mark in case of adult. Now we can after that we can discuss its life cycle. Now here the life cycle stages of such a Mylabris pustulata, we show the stages such as egg, larva, pupae and adult. Okay, now we can see all the stages comparing. Here the eggs, they are laid in masses in soil where grasshoppers normally deposit the eggs. Okay, before that we should know, okay, grasshoppers, the females, they particularly laid the eggs on the surface of the soil or inside the crevices of the soil. Okay, here again the habitat of such a blister beetle is that the female which can lay a number of eggs in soil where the grasshoppers normally deposit eggs, means the egg deposition habitat of both, that is blister beetle and grasshoppers, they are same. Okay, now each female lays about 100 to 2000 eggs depending on quantity of food they ingest. Okay, means whatever the protein material which getting by food. Okay, so what it is, the female which can lay near about 100 to 2000 eggs depending on the quantity of food they ingest. Now, the such a egg, they hatch in near about 15 days. Now, after that, within a span of incubation phase of eggs of 15 days, after that the hatchlings they come out or tiny larvae they come out. Okay, now such a egg or they hatch out in the active larvae, or what we say is that the hatchlings that feeds upon the soil dwelling insects. Now such a larvae, okay, now such a tiny larvae, they have a particular, that is biting, chewing, okay, kind of mouth part. Okay, now they start feeding on the soil dwelling insects. Now such a insects, they including again the pest, and they do not cause any damage to the crop. Okay, why? Because they are crawling on the surface of soil, and therefore they cannot cause any damage to initial stage to the crop. Okay, now the newly hatched larvae, they searches for the grasshopper acorns. Okay, after finding one, it chews its way into rod and begins to feed. Okay, means what? Here such a larvae, okay, they crawl, okay, they travel and find out the eggs of grasshopper, or such a grasshoppers, they the female, they can deposit the eggs in pod. Okay, now or the cases, okay, or what we say is that the pod. Now here such a larvae, they find out the eggs or the pods of such a grasshoppers, and they start feeding on the eggs. Here after the latter stages of the larvae, they are bulky and sluggish with reduced legs. Okay, now the larval forms have several instars. Now here a first stage, okay, which is or initially the larval stages, they are voracious feeder. Okay, why? Because for their development they need more amount of food. Okay, now so they are voracious feeder, so if they feeding more, okay, then they stop feeding again, they slow the all the procedure slows down. Okay, now the first larval instar, okay, which enter after molting, which enter into the second larval instar. Okay, now like this manner, okay, here the several larval instars they form. Okay, and at the last, the last larval instar, which is larger in size and the skin which is thick as compared to the former, and now which start forming the pupae, or which start entering into the third developing phase, that is the pupal phase. Now after that, okay, the pupa at the last molt, the larva again becomes active, crawls out of the grasshopper egg pod and pupates in the soil. Okay, now this is what formation of the pupa. After that, the adult formation. Okay, now the adult beetle which emerge out from the pupa and remains active as from the from feeding of inflorescence, then pollens, petals of flowers. Okay, or particularly on which host plant they are present. Okay, such a adult stages, okay, They feeding on the particular host plant and the plant parts such as their pollens, their petals, their flowers. Okay, now like this. And now here the life cycle which again repeated. The female which deposit number of eggs and again eggs they develop into the larvae and again pupae and again adult. Now the life cycle which continues. Now after that we can discuss its nature of damage. Now here the nature of damage here, only the adult stages are destructive. Okay, adult stage which is the destructive stage. Here the beetles they attack the inflorescence and feed on pollens and petals of flowers and therefore they adversely affecting the grain setting. Okay, now in India it is a serious pest of Fijian pea plant. So it feeds on flowers and developing pods, then reducing the crop yield. Now the cathartin which released by adults, which can severely injure the livestock, okay, livestock then particularly the horses. Now here hay which is contaminated with the body fluid of such a crushed beetle, which can cause irritation in the stomach lining, then small intestine, bladder and urinary tract of the horse. Okay, now here you can see the horse. Okay, horse which is feeding on the whatever the grass material. Okay, now if such a material which is already contaminated with the body fluid of this distributor. Okay, now such a body fluid or the cathartin which enter into the stomach of horse, where which can cause irritation in the stomach lining, then small intestine, bladder and urinary tract of the horse. Now it reduces the calcium level in the blood. Now animals who have ingested the cathartin, okay, may exhibit a sign of colic including the excessive salivation, sweating, cramps and urinary drain. Okay, now a fatal dose which will include a fever, depression, shock and ultimately the death. Okay, along with horse. Okay, many animals are there, okay, which are feeding on such a hay or feeding on the grass or the plant parts. Okay, now if those animals they get infected, if they come in contact with such a contaminated fluid or fluid particularly the cathartin. Okay, now they suffer from these symptoms. Okay, and if they cannot control, okay, or one cannot control the symptoms of such animal, then finally the animals they shows the death. Okay, this is what about the nature of damage. Now after that we have the control. Okay, so how we can control this population of blister beetles. Now here such a pest which can be managed by cultural and chemical methods. Now the cultural methods they include the adult beetles, they are trapped by light source and they kill physically or using kerosinized water. Okay, after that such a beetles they can be collected by insect nets without touching and killed in kerosinized water. Okay, suppose we are going to collect them, so one should take precaution, so do not touch them. Why? Because they can cause blister to man. Okay, now so by using hand net. Okay, hand net we have to collect them and we can transfer them without touching into the kerosinized water. Okay, this is what the cultural method. Now after that if we can discuss its chemical control method, which includes the dusting. Okay, dusting the crop with methyl parathion, okay, or endosulfan, particularly the concentration at that is 2d or 4d at parameter that is hectares. Okay, but here such a dose, okay, at 20 kg per hectare. Okay, Now, this is what the use of parathion, methyl parathion or endosulfan. After that, the spraying of monocrotophos, the concentration that is 0.04% of such a spray once in 10 to 12 days of interval. Okay. Now, after that, dusting of 10% BSC at the rate that is 25 kg per hectare and which is effective on the control of such an adult species. Now, here the adult beetle population which can be suppressed by spraying the emulsion of pesticides like again quinolphos, then phosalon or so many chemical compounds or so many insecticides. Okay, now this is what all about the control measures of such a blister beetle. Okay, in next lecture we discuss with the next insect. Okay, thank you so much.